Building a Model Solenoid Engine, Part 1, Getting Started. I've been wanting to build my own model steam engine for quite a while now, but I need some experience first with soldering and modifying materials. So my idea was to convert my Lego solenoid engine into a fake steam plant kind of concept. So I will start off with building the fake boiler. This will house the power supply unit that powers the engine and all the other electronics in this build. Fair warning, I'm completely inexperienced, so if you want to know how to not build a model steam plant, this is the video for you. And here you can see me shaping a piece of brass using a roll of duct tape. It turns out that this roll of duct tape is actually a perfect fit for the power supply. I know the power supply looks a bit crude at the moment, but that's just for my own protection while I'm testing it. And here I'm using yet another roll of tape, because I figured that the inner diameter of this tape is actually perfect for keeping the brass cylinder in place while I solder it. It's also the exact right diameter for the power supply. And here's the cheap gas burner I bought from Gamma. It's cheap, but it should get the job done. And here's the Griffon soldering set that I bought. It comes complete with cleaning pads, a roll of solder for copper and brass soldering. It's quite thick. And finally the flux to make the solder flow properly through capillary action. And here I'm getting ready for soldering on my balcony. First, it is important to clean the surface that you are going to solder. And doing another test fit to see if it's all proper. Then it's time to apply the flux, which happens off screen because I'm a little bit of a silly person and didn't check my camera. Well, here goes nothing. Time to light the gas burner and try to do my first soldering job. I'm heating the metal. And I screwed up because I was way too impatient with applying the solder. Instead, I just kind of ended up melting the solder with my gas burner instead of properly heating the material and then applying the solder to the material, which causes it to melt. The flux causing it to flow into the seam, and voila, you have a way better soldering job than what I just did. Anyways, I've cooled off the material, I've cleaned it again, and now I'm applying flux again so I can do my second attempt. And here you can see me being a hard learner, because I'm making the same mistake again. I should be waiting for the material to heat up properly, for the flux to boil, then I should apply the solder. But I'm way too impatient again. But finally I understood what I already knew from years of soldering experience with electronics. And there we go, my first solder joint. I did forget to film the process, but luckily there's plenty more to solder. I realized that the flux may flow better if I put it on its side. So here's my third attempt. It's going better already. Still a little bit too impatient, and maybe my gas burner is a little bit too small after all. But as the saying goes, practice makes perfect. Well, halfway there anyways. And here's the final result. Well, there's a little bit of a gap that was created while soldering. Unfortunately, solder has gotten in there and it's all stuck like that now. But oh well, it will be hidden anyways with the wood cladding later on. I've bent a piece of tin sheet into another cylinder, and I'm gonna use that to make the base or the firebox of the boiler. You see me pointing out the hole that I will cut in there. I changed my mind later, I'm actually gonna do it a little bit differently. And here I'm wasting my time and sating my curiosity, because I wanna try if I can solder this tin can, which of course won't work. And here's my change of plans for the firebox hole. I realized it's way easier to make this hole this way. Problem is, I don't have any professional tools nor the space for them. Don't have any machinery to do this kind of work. I have to do it all by hand with what little tools I have available. And here's the end result of my hard labor. It's not perfect yet, but getting there. Now I do need some end caps to keep things in place. So I'm using a marker to get a proper reference of the diameter of the tube. And after a lot of sawing and cutting, this is the first one. Pretty good, especially since it's done very crudely by hand. Oh, there we go, the firebox, bottom and top plate, and the boiler itself. Here I'm deciding to fit the boiler inside the firebox, in contrary to my design. It just looks better, especially when I'm gonna put on the cladding later. So I modified the top plate to fit inside the firebox. It will later be kept in place with screws. So after a whole lot of cutting and bending, the top cap has now become a bottom cap for the boiler, and this will fit straight inside the firebox. Here I've drilled a bunch of holes, namely for the screws that keep the boiler in place in the firebox. I will also drill some additional holes here to put a little front plate on there with maybe a logo, something fancy. This will keep the firebox nicely tied together and will kind of hide that ugly seam as well. And here I fitted an M3 screw. I'm using these screws because I have a mountain of them still, so yeah, why not? That being said, these are very cheap screws and not very well machined, so they don't always fit that well. And there we go, all screws in place. And now test fitting the boiler, and it's pretty perfect actually. It's very stable and very sturdy. Especially with quite a heavy weight of the power supply unit in there, it will be held in place quite properly. I also realized that I still need to drill a hole in the bottom for the power supply cables. So there you go, all done. And now comes the fun part of doing the wood cladding. So I bought little strips of balsa wood. It's a nice dark wood and it gives it more of a classy vibe. So here am I applying it. I'm just using standard super glue, since this won't actually contain hot water and steam, so I don't need to worry about it heating up and the glue melting again. Now you might have noticed I applied the first one right next to the seam. This is because I don't want to have to glue one right on top of the seam. So doing it this way, it should work out alright. I also want to put the first one as straight as possible, because if you start out skewed, you'll end up skewed and it will just look all wonky and weird. And there we go, that's quite a bit done already. It's looking quite nifty. It definitely gives it a bit of more of an expensive look. Now of course this wood cladding needs some pretty looking brass bands around it, so that's what I'm making right now. I've got some brass strips. And yes, this is me using scissors to drill the holes out further. My drill has died and, well, I want to keep going, so guess it's more manual labor for me. And here's the boiler with the brass rings attached. And on the backside is where the screws are. Since this will be against a wall anyways on the model, it won't be that visible, so I figured it would be fine. And here I'm sawing a round piece of brass for the top cap. And here I'm soldering a brass ring. Now I tied this down with a piece of duct tape, which is of course an horrible idea, as you can see. I'm honestly not sure what I was thinking here, but I did eventually come back to my senses. And here I'm using my pliers with some elastic bands to keep it in place. I cleaned it up and put some new flux on there, solder it, and now it's much better. There we go. Now to shape the top cap, I again got lucky and found a piece of round wood that is the exact diameter of the boiler including the cladding. So this will be perfect to make the top cap. It's almost there, I just need to bend and hammer it a little bit more, and then I can fit that brass ring on there, solder it all together, and then I should have a decent top cap. Of course I need to drill some holes for the chimney and for the wiring. Now remember what I said about buying a cheap gas burner? Well, I regret this now, because it has already broken. At first it started producing big old flames, and then it completely died on me. I have taken it apart, but I honestly can't tell what's wrong with it. Lesson learned, don't buy cheap unless you know what you're doing. Luckily, there's some other things I can still do, such as making that brass front plate or the logo, as well as a lower little plate. And I also gotta attach the whole thing to the bottom plate. The top cap and the chimney will have to wait until I have a gas burner again. So I'll be ending the video here. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did and haven't already, subscribe and don't forget to click the little notification bell. And I'll see you guys next video. Goodbye.